You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of a country's diversity. Let's begin the show with the Queen of Hills, Shimla, that not just woos tourists with its natural beauty, but also presents them a unique blend of traditional and modern culture to its fairs and festivals. Recently, it played host to the International Trade Fair to provide a platform to small businesses and artisans to display their products. Have a look.
Hordes of tourists thronged the hill town of Shimla as it hosted the five-day International Trade Fair. It was organized collectively by a private partner in collaboration with the state government and PhD Chamber of Commerce and Industry. People from various parts of the country and even from other countries like Afghanistan took part in the expo to promote their culture as well as their products.
And people, they are showing lots of love towards our products, especially towards our dry fruit, because Afghanistan is the only country that we have organic dry fruits, and they like our quality of dry fruits. We have jewelries also, Afghan jewelries here, they are participating. Afghan carpet is there, special carpets, handmade carpets. And due to the COVID, from past 2 years, they are not participating here. But dry fruits, we are participating this year. Afghan carpet and Afghan jewelry, they didn't came. Because of some problem due to the government problems, they were not able to come. Visa and all problem was there, so they weren't able to come, but at all response is very good. We are happy.
Various government departments related to industries and self-help groups also set up their stalls at the event that aimed to provide an opportunity to small businesses for networking and branding their products. Organizers said that they chose Shimla because of its wonderful weather, and their main motive was to repair the closed tourism business and the economic loss caused to the people during the corona period.
Hum un logon ke liye show karna chahte hain ab 2 saal baad taki wo log ab jo 2 saal se ghar pe baithe hue the aur jo thak gaye the aur jinko kuch bhi kaam nahi tha aur unka प्रोफेशन ही ये था कि वो अपने प्रोडक्ट्स की प्रदर्शनी लगाएं या उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करें. ये उन लोगों की डिमांड पे हमने ये शिमला को चूज़ किया. शिमला का वेदर बहुत अच्छा था, इसलिए हमने इसको चूज़ किया. हमने सरकार से हमने गुजारिश करी थी, जिसने सरकार ने माना, सरकार ने हमें अनुमति दी इस बात की, और सरकार का पूरा सहयोग हमें रहा.
The food fest organized on the sidelines of the trade expo served as a treat for foodies. Variety of cuisines ranging from Indian to Mughlai to continental were there for visitors to relish. Desserts like jalebi were equally savored by everyone.
यहाँ में बहुत अच्छा लगा. हमने पानी पूरी खाई, चाउमीन खाई, खास तौर से हमने निजाम भाई के यहाँ पर खाना खाया. बहुत अच्छा खाना था, बहुत अच्छा लगा. यहाँ पर हर चीज अच्छी है यहाँ पर.
Such events are a great initiative to promote the culture and tourism of the region while providing consumers with an opportunity to avail the best products in the market.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people and act as a guiding force for many. Today, we will take you to the shrine of Saint Hazrat Char Raju, where people of all faiths assembled to seek the blessings of holy saint. Communal harmony is a required facet for maintaining peace and tranquility in a multicultural and diverse society like India. For this, the social fabric of the country has to be nurtured by connecting all individuals from all spheres with one another.
a major role in connecting individuals of different religious communities and bringing them under one roof in the Hyderabad district of Telangana is done by the Dargah of Hazrat Shah Raju. People from far and wide visit his holy site to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint.
हर आदमी को फायदे हमारा खिदा पक्का हो जो खिदे से आएंगे वो फैज पाएंगे ऐसा बारगा है जो कुछ भी नहीं तो कोई खाली नहीं जाता यहाँ से हर आदमी को मिलता मगर उसका यकीन पक्का होना और आए सब एक ही नहीं से आना एक ही दे से दिल साफ रख के आना बराबर मिलता
Born in the year 1002 AH in Bijapur city, the saint holds the title of Katal As Shah Raju Katal Husseini, used to struggle with nafas or soul. Well known for his pious personality all around the Deccan region, the saint was famous for the miracles that he performed. Devotees perceive the saint for his connection with Khwaja Bandi Nawaz of Gulbarga and his knowledge of Allah. People of all faiths have deep faith in the saint who throughout his entire life worked for the welfare of humanity.
मैं पिछले 20-25 साल से यहाँ पर आता हूँ हजरत राजू सत्तार साहब क़िबला की जो है हजरत तानेशाह के ज़माने से जो है आपका जो है वो उर्स शरीफ होता है आप तानेशाह के लिए और हैदराबाद के लिए बहुत इनके फैज़ है और हम भी यहाँ सर फैज़ पाते हैं
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Hazrat Syed Shah Raju Muhammad have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Paddy fields in India's southern Kottayam city have turned pink with blooming pink water lilies, wowing tourists and locals alike. The city's Panachikar paddy fields were filled with pink water lilies and tourists were seen enjoying the boat rides amid the flowers.
Here you can see that it is really beautiful and we are having a lot of lotus flowers in our hand. It is really seasonal and we are really enjoying and there are lot of side activities here like boating and everything.
Although the region sees a huge crowd of visitors during this time of year, the numbers have dwindled from the past 2 years due to the COVID-19 pandemic. An animal conservation center in India's northern Mathura city is treating injured elephants in a bid to give them a better and healthy life. Ahead of the National Elephant Appreciation Day, the health workers and caretakers at Wildlife SOS Conservation Center treated the elephants with feet and leg illnesses. At least 28 elephants that were freed and brought to Mathura from different parts of the country were currently being treated at the center that has a thermal imaging camera facility, observation cum treatment area and crane facilities for lifting injured or sick elephants.
इस जानवरों को जो बाकी बचे हुए जिंदगी है रोड में मर के उधर ही गिर के मरने से अच्छा है कम से कम उनको थोड़ा जिंदगी और फ्री में और अपने पसंद वाला खाना खाएं अपने पसंद वाला नहा ले क्योंकि अभी आपको पता होगा रोड में बहुत गर्मी में ऐसे ऐसे घूमता रहता है कभी मैलों दूर जाने के बाद उनको पानी का एक पाइप या नल मिलता है 150 लीटर 200 लीटर पानी पीने वाला जानवर को अब सुबह से शाम तक पानी नहीं पिलाएगा तो उसका पूरा बिहेवियर पूरा अंदर का क्या क्या गुजर रहा होगा तो ये सब थोड़ा हम अच्छा सा इनको पसंद वाला पानी दे दे पानी में घूम ले और कितना कितना बचा हुआ जिंदगी है वो हम मैक्सिमम कोशिश करते हैं उनको अच्छे से जिंदगी देने
टू मार्क द ओकेजन द एलिफेंट्स वर गिवन अ बाथ एंड फेड फ्रूट्स एज अ ट्रीट द कंजर्वेशन सेंटर दैट ऑल्सो हाउसेज अ हॉस्पिटल वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन 2018 and aims at treating injured, sick or geriatric elephants. India has over 50% of Asiatic elephants considered to be the most intelligent animals. Elephants in India, numbering around 25,000 in the wild, are an endangered species. Authorities in India's northern Amritsar city are taking steps to stop stubble burning by creating awareness among farmers about its disadvantages. Three vehicles deployed in Amritsar went around in the villages making announcements, distributing pamphlets to farmers and educating them about the adverse effects of burning crop residues.
हम दो तीन लेवल पे इस पे एक्सरसाइज कर रहे हैं. एक तो हम एजुकेशन वाला पार्ट है, एजुकेशन और अवेयरनेस का जो हम फार्मर्स के लिए कर रहे हैं. हमारी वैन्स वगैरह है, विलेजेस में जा रही हैं. दूसरी तरफ हमने उनको इन्फोर्समेंट और पिनल एक्शन है, जिसमें हमारी टीम्स मौके पे जाके जो भी कोई किसान है, अगर वो बार बार मानने ना माने और वहाँ पे आग लगा रहे हैं, तो हमें वहाँ पे जो एनवायरनमेंट जो पोल्यूशन डिपार्टमेंट है उनकी तरफ से वो एक पेनल्टी भी उन पे लगाई जा रही है.
The stubble burning is seen as one of the key factors contributing to smog and dust engulfing New Delhi every year in May, June and October, November. Meanwhile, farmers in Indian capital New Delhi were using biodecomposer spray to decompose the crop residue into compost to prevent burning stubble and increase crop production.
It's been said that anything violence can do, peace could do better. Peaceful coexistence and harmony are the key features of India as a nation that has left the entire world spellbounded. Today in our episode of My India, we will see one such example from Cuttack city of Odisha, where Muslim artisans have been making decorative items for Hindu festivals for years.
India is home to a number of religious groups, caste and ethnicities that live together harmoniously in the country. Examples of this peaceful and harmonious coexistence can be spotted at every nook and corner of the nation. One such example is that of Muslim artisans in Cuttack city of Odisha, who has been making decorative items for Hindu festivals like Durga Puja and others for generations, as a symbol of brotherhood and bohemi between the two communities.
ये कटक शहर भाईचारा का शहर है. हमको बहुत गर्व लगता है कि हम मुस्लिमों के ये पूजे के काम में, मैंने दशहरे के काम में हम हाथ लगाते हैं, बहुत खुशी लगता है. और ये मैंने ऐसा नहीं कि हिंदू मुस्लिम सब एक बराबर रहते हैं उड़ीसा में, बहुत खुशी लगता है.
These are the residents of Chungbhati Gali in Balu Bazar area of Cuttack city. These artisans have been making decorative items for Hindu gods and goddesses for years. Every year before the festival of Durga Puja and Dashera, all members of the family start making decorative items for pandals, statues and effigies of goddess Durga and Ravan. Since the last 2 years, their business was adversely affected due to the pandemic, as public gatherings were strictly prohibited. However, this year the business has somehow witnessed a revival.
हम लोग मुस्लिम हो के भी देवी काम सब करते हैं, हम लोग को बहुत खुशी लगता है और ये काम में हम लोग चल भी जाता है. हमारा पैसा है, बिजनेस कहने चलेगा, इसी में हम लोग चलता है. अगला साल से बैठा है, काम कुछ नहीं. इस साल थोड़ा रेजा पुरजा काम आया, कोरोना की वजह से काम बहुत ढीला है. हम लोग बाहर का काम भी जा करते हैं, कटक के वगैरह, उड़ीसा का और विभिन्न जगह में हम लोग जाते हैं, वहाँ का भी काम करता है.
It is through their artistry and love for their fellow citizens that these artisans are presenting a beautiful picture of undivided and united India.
And now we will meet the 17-year-old genius from Saharanpur city of Uttar Pradesh, who has developed a social media application which allows connectivity without sharing of any contacts.
It's been said that creativity is thinking up new things, but innovation is the ability of doing new things. Home to a number of innovators and creators like Aryabhatta, APJ Abdul Kalam, C.V. Raman and more, creations by Indian minds have always had a capacity to bring about a significant amount of change all over the world. Next in the list of creators is Siddharth Tyagi, a 17-year-old boy from Saharanpur city of Uttar Pradesh, who has created an app that enables people to communicate without sharing their contact information. Named as Stoment, the application was launched on 15th of August this year and could be easily downloaded from Play Store on Android mobile phones.
क्योंकि एक location based social network है, तो ये सभी लोगों को connect करता है। क्योंकि हम देखते हैं कि दूसरे social networks में हमें communication करने के लिए contacts, followers, friends इन सब की जरूरत पड़ती है, लेकिन Stoment में इसी की requirement नहीं है। आप बिना contact के भी अनजान लोगों तक भी अपना message 2 किलोमीटर के रेडियस में पहुंचा सकते हैं, और जैसे जैसे आप पोस्ट डालेंगे आपका रेडियस भी बढ़ता रहेगा। इसमें कई और मुख्य फीचर भी हैं, जैसे करंट लोकेशन का, आप जहां पर हैं आपके आसपास कौन सी पोस्ट डाली जा रही है, शेयर की जा रही है, वो आपको दिखती रहेंगी। पॉपुलर का, स्टॉमेंट कम्युनिटी में सबसे ज्यादा वोटेड या ट्रेंडिंग पोस्ट कौन सी है वो आपको उस सेक्शन में दिखेंगी। एक फीड ऑप्शन भी है आपके लिए, वो स्पेशल फीचर है। जैसे आप फिलहाल सहारनपुर में हैं और आप लखनऊ जाने वाले हैं, आप चाहते हैं लखनऊ जाने के बाद भी आपको सहारनपुर में हो रही डल रही पोस्ट के बारे में पता लगता रहे, तो आप सहारनपुर में फीड सेट कर सकते हैं। फिर आप कहीं भी चले जाएं, आपको सहारनपुर की पोस्ट भी फीड सेक्शन में दिखती रहेंगी।
Stoment is a location-based app that enables a user to communicate within a radius of 2 kilometers to 20 kilometers without sharing any contact with others. Tyagi, who has just finished school, drew his inspiration from Prime Minister's Atmanirbhar Bharat campaign and wanted to create something out of the box for all Indians to use. Siddharth comes from a middle-class family of farmers and his parents are extremely proud of his endeavors.
सिद्धार्थ के अंदर बचपन से एक ऐसी इच्छा थी कुछ अलग करूं, तो उसने बोला पापा लैपटॉप लेके दो, तो मैंने उसको लैपटॉप लेके दिया। उसके बाद वो दिन रात इस काम में लगा रहता था, हमें समझ में नहीं आया शुरू में कर क्या रहा है। फिर इसने एक दिन बोला पापा मैं एक एप्लीकेशन डेवलप करना चाहता हूँ। मुझे लगा ये ऐसे ही बोल रहा है जैसे नॉर्मल बच्चे बोल ही देते हैं। मैंने कहा ठीक करूँ, लेकिन जब इसने करीब 4 महीने पहले इसने कहा पापा मैं बहुत नजदीक हूँ इस चीज़ के, तो मुझे विश्वास नहीं हुआ। मैंने देखा इसने दिखाया मेरे को, मैं चौंक गया कि इसने ऐसे कैसे कर दिया।
He worked hard for around 1.5 years during the pandemic to create this out of the box application.
Next we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section World in Focus.
Tokyo Station is the entry point for visitors. The Marunouchi Station building was constructed in Tokyo as a symbol of Japan's modernization and developed along with Japan's representative business district. Its long history witnessed many historical events. In 2012, Tokyo Station, an important national cultural property, was rebuilt to its original appearance.
いろんなあの国の方々を迎えるのにやっぱりこういうまあ広いまあ敷地でまあゆったりとしたこうまあ真っすぐでまあ正面にちょうど皇居があるっていうまあロケーションなんかはすごくまあ海外の方なんかもまあ喜んでもらえるんじゃないかなと。日本を代表する有数なのオフィス街ですし、まあ日本のまあ原点じゃないですけどまあ現代風のものとミックスされていてまあすごくいい場所だと思います。
The interior of the dome has been rebuilt with gypsum with the latest architectural technology. Many tourists visit the square to take pictures with the backdrop of Tokyo Station.
誕生日が1週間前で、はい、でお祝いしてて昨日からでそのままなんかいいとこで写真撮りたいなと思って東京駅で写真撮ってました。
はい、建物が
よくウェディングフォトで使ってるんですよ、ここ。なんで、ここにしようって決めました。
Recently, wedding photos have been increasing as visitors are spellbound with the beauty of the Tokyo Station. Tokyo Station has been loved by all generations and is attracting attention as a tourist destination around the world. Scientists at Nanyang Technological University are tackling food waste by turning discarded durian husk into antibacterial gel bandages. The process extracts cellulose powder from the fruit's husk after they are sliced and freeze-dried, then mixes it with glycerol. This mixture becomes soft hydrogel, which is then cut into bandage strips.
So this project is about converting the durian husk into antimicrobial hydrogel-based bandages. So how do we do that? In Singapore, we consume about 12 million durians a year. So beside the flesh, we can't do much about the husk and the seeds. And this causes environmental pollution, all this kind of thing. So what we have done is we have developed a cellulose extraction technology to sort of take the cellulose out of these durian husks and then convert them into antimicrobial hydrogel-based bandages for biomedical applications.
Compared to conventional bandages, the moisture retained in these biological hydrogel bandages are also able to keep wound areas cooler and moist, which can accelerate healing. The researchers say using waste materials and yeast for the antimicrobial bandages is more cost-effective than the production of conventional bandages, whose antimicrobial properties come from more expensive metallic compounds like silver or copper ions. Otemachi and Morunouchi in Tokyo are representative business towns. Big buildings are lined up. At lunchtime, hungry business workers go out for lunch. Nearby, food trucks line up in building squares and park. The food trucks business has been active in Japan for several years. These days, popular dishes include Vietnamese sandwiches, Asian chicken rice, and charcoal grilled fish. In order to attract customers, the restaurant offers trendy dishes.
Umioroshi chicken bento. Bento desu ne. Hai. So desu ne, ironna shurui ga aru node, ano, aki mo konai shi.
It is a Japanese noodle food truck popular among foreign tourists. In this truck, special containers are used to make it easy to carry around.
Shoyu tonkotsu ramen というのが一番人気なんですけども、豚骨特有の臭みとかなく食べやすいラーメンなので、ぜひご賞味いただければなと思ってます。店舗で売り上げ下がっちゃってるので、その分やっぱりフードトラックで賄えたらいいなと思ってて、まあいいところ悪いところありますけども、そういうふうになんとかやってます。
It feels like a luxurious food truck. And this traditional Japanese dish that is dipped in sweet sauce and grilled over charcoal. The popularity of food trucks in Japan is giving new hope to restaurant industry amid COVID-19.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.